Hello everyone, good morning students. Dear students, in previous class we take and discuss a very important chapter of the syllabus related to your topic, which is circles. And in that class we take and solve some important questions, some important theorem based on them. Now in today's class we also take and solve some important theorem related to the chapter circles and proving it. So first we take a very important theorem, student, and the theorem is, this is very important for you and your upcoming examination. Theorem is, the angle subtended by an arc, the angle subtended by an arc of a circle at the center is double the angle subtended by it at any point on the remaining part of the circle. Dear friend, this is a very important theorem based on related to that chapter circle. Okay, so let's see what is the process to proving that theorem. Okay, this is one of the most important theorem of your syllabus. So let's see, dear friends, what is the process for proving that theorem. Look here first, dear friend. First of all, we draw a circle and let us take A, B, B and arc of a circle, and let C be any point on the remaining part of the circle. Okay, now let us take O be the center of the circle and we join OA, OB and AB also. Now also we have to do some construction. We just join AC and BC respectively. So first of all we write the given. In given we can write what? A circle C, the angle subtended by that arc at the center is angle AOB. Okay, so now in given we write a circle C with center O and radius R, in which the angle in which AB, B and R, okay, AB, B and R of the circle, and the angle subtended by that arc at the center of the circle is what? It is given to prove. What I proved, dear students? We have to show that the angle AOB is same as 2 times angle ACB. Now we have to do some construction also. We just join OC and reduce to D. Now look, construction. There is some construction is there. Join OC and reduce to D. Join OC and produce to D. That is, now look, Now let's see its proof. Okay. Now let's see its proof, dear students. So now proof first of all. So now in triangle AOC. In triangle AOC, this is AOD is the exterior angle, and we know that the exterior angle is equal to the sum of its two opposite interior angle. So means angle AOD is equal to angle OAC. Angle OAC plus angle OCA. Angle OCA. Okay, take equation number 1. But from figure, but OA is equal to OC, which is equal to R radius. Now look, OA is equal to OC is equal to R, then that is, we know that the angle opposite to equal sides are also equal, that is angle OAC is equal to angle OCA. Angle OCA, we take equation number 2. Now, using equation 1 and 2. Now, using equation 1 and 2, we just put angle OAC is equal to angle OCA. So, that is from there, angle AOD means exterior angle for that triangle AOD is equal to angle OCA plus angle OCA, that is angle OAOD is equal to 2 times angle OCA. Take equation number 3. We adding them. So now here we put angle OAC is equal to angle OCA. So OCA, that is 2 times angle O C and A. Now look. Now, similarly, dear friends, in triangle OBC, OCB, that exterior angle, angle BOD, exterior angle BOD is equal to 2 times angle OCB, that one. Similarly, we apply same process to 2 times angle OCB, that is equation number 2. Now adding 3 and 4. Now add 3 and 4. So that is angle AOD plus angle BOD is equal to 2, take common, that is angle OCA plus angle OCB. Now from figure, dear friend, from figure, angle AOD plus this is the angle AOB now is equal to 2 times angle OCA, and angle OCB is what angle ACB? Angle ACB, hence proof. Okay, so dear friend, in this way you can prove that theorem. This is one of the most important theorem of your syllabus. So please, dear students, do more and more practices of that type of questions. After that, you can prove each and every theorem based on this topic. Also, you can solve all the questions of your NCERT exercise based on that theorem. Now, we take and solve some other important questions or theorem based on circle. Okay. Now, let's see. we take a very important question based on circle, and the question is, in the given figure, in the given figure, angle ABC is angle ABC is 69 degree. Angle ACB is equal to 31 degree. Find angle BDC. This one is find that. Okay, this is the question. This is a very important question related to your topic. Now look, what is the process and the figure is, look. Now, this is BC. BC AD. Now, pair B line. AB. AC. BB and CD respectively. And here, this is one angle. ABC. ABC, that angle is equal to 69 degrees. This is 69. Now let's see its solution. It is given that, first of all, we are given angle ABC is what? 69 degrees for that question. And ACB, that angle is called 31 degrees. This is what? 31 degree. यानी कि angle ACB is what? 31 degree. Now, in triangle ABC, we apply the angle sum property of the triangle using angle sum property of the triangle. So means angle BAC, okay, angle BAC plus angle ABC plus angle ACB is equal to 180 degree. Now we find angle BAC plus angle ABC is what? 69 plus ACB is what? 31. 180 degree. Now angle BAC plus 100 na? Yes. So 100 is equal to 180. Now from their distance we transfer that side. So angle BAC is equal to 180 minus 100, that is 80 degree. Thus this, now so angle BAC, which we find that 80 degree. And we know that the theorem, just we discuss about the key angle in the same segments are also equal now. Thus, so you rewrite it this way. Thus, we know that the angle in the same segment R equal, that is angle BAC is equal to angle BDC. So that is angle BDC is also same as angle BAC, that is what? 80 degree. This is the required solution of the given question. Okay, so in this way, dear friend, you can solve each and every question of your NCERT exercise based on this topic. This is the very important question. So please do more and more practices of that type of questions, and after that you can solve each and every questions of your NCERT exercise based on these topics. Okay, this is the very important question, dear friends. Now we take and solve some other important questions. This is the very important question. Now we take some other important question. And the question is, two circles are drawn. This is a very important question. Two circles are drawn with sides AB with sides AB comma AC of a triangle ABC as diameter. Two circles drawn with sides. Two circles are drawn with sides AB. Okay, comma AC of a triangle ABC. AC of a triangle ABC as diameter. The circles intersect at a point D. The circle intersect at a point D. At a point D. Prove that D lies on BC. Now let's see its solution. So two circles are drawn with sides AB. Okay, and AC as a diameter. So let's see. So first of all, we draw a triangle ABC and we draw two circles as AB and AC as the diameter. So first of all, we draw first means OB the center. So like that, first one is that, like here, AB as a diameter, AB and AC are is the diameter of a circle. And now AC is also the diameter of the circle, dear students. So now O dash stay as here. Like that, okay.
Here
both AB and AC are the diameter of this, and that intersect at a point D. Here, this is the intersect at point D. We have to show that D, prove that D lies on BC. We have to show that D lies on BC. This is the question. Now, if we have to show that BDC is a straight line, then we have it is clear that this is the
okay, now we have to do some construction. We just join AB.
Now, we join AD. Now, in the semicircle, yes, A oho. Now this is the diameter of the circle, so we draw in this way, dear friends. This is the diameter. AB is the diameter. So we can draw in this way. This is the diameter. So we can draw the circle in this way, and this one is draw. Look, this is the diameter. So we just join them. Okay. Now, in the semicircle ABD, now in the semicircle ABD, we know that the angle in the semicircle is a 90 degree, so angle ADB, that is angle ADB is equal to 90 degree. Take question number 1, because of we know that the angle in a semicircle is always 90 degrees. Similarly in triangle ADC, this is also the semicircle, this is some semicircle, so angle in the semicircle, this is ADC is also 90 degree. ADC, because of you write here, what you write is the angle. We know that the angle in a semicircle is 90 degrees. Since angles in a is 90. Now adding 1 and 2. 1 plus 2. If we adding 1 plus 2, so angle ADB plus angle ADC is equal to 180. Now from figure, angle ADB and angle ADC is same as angle BDC. This is angle BDC is equal to 180 degree. Thus, in this way, dear student, BDC is a 180 degree. In this way, BDC is a straight line, thus we can say that BDC is a straight line. The BDC is a straight line, that is we can say that D lies on BC, hence proved. So in this way, dear friend, you can solve and prove that type of theorem. So please dear friend, do more and more practices of that type of question which we discuss in that class. Now in next class we take and solve some other important theorem and questions related to circle. So first you revise and do more and more practices of each and every questions of the syllabus. Okay, now in next class we take and solve some other important theorems and questions based on the chapter circles. Okay, dear friends, so now thanks to all.